So in today's lecture, we are going to discuss, or can I say revise, one of the most easily complicated chapters of SFM, that is Forex. I have got calls from many students who always told me, sir, SFM nikal jata hai, sirf Forex aur derivatives atka deta hai. These are the two chapters which are capable enough for us to not clear, because we do not understand ki sum solve kaisa karne ka chalu karne ka. How do we start and what have they actually asked? What rate? Many times they give us many rate. 4-5 rate de deta hai, toh kaun sa seedha, upar, niche, what to do? We are clueless, we blank out and we end up solving it in the wrong manner. So, let us try now to revise this chapter and to come out of all the fears that we have for this particular chapter of Forex as such. Now, tell me, Forex, iska full form kya hota hai? Can I say it is nothing but foreign exchange? Right? Matlab anything or any currency which is not the currency of my country and which I am entering into a transaction into. Matlab can I say, if supposing I am an Indian, right? I enter my normal day-to-day transactions in, can I say, my home currency, which is nothing but the rupee, if I have to state it symbolically, or if I have to state it as per the ISO classification, can I say we say INR, right? Rupee or INR, right? So can I say, is currency mein to mera normal transaction hota hai, day to day basis, monthly basis, yearly basis, or even minute basis? Because if I go, normally say, if I go to any shop to buy a toffee, supposing I go to buy a dairy milk or a bone bill, I will not tell him that don't take rupees, I have dollars, or don't take rupees, I have pounds. He will always understand his own currency, right? So can I say the first thing that we need to be clear is the two terms, home currency and foreign currency, right? Can I say home currency is the currency of the country in which the normal business transactions in that country take place? And can I say foreign currency is the currency which is not the home currency? Right? Because if for Indian, rupee is home currency, rupee cannot be foreign currency. Am I clear with this part? Right? Let's go to the next part. So sir, but ye toh foreign exchange ki baat ho gayi. The chapter that we have is foreign exchange exposure. So sir, exposure kya hoega? Can I say if I am a person for whom the normal currency is rupee? Matlab main meri country mein rupees mein deal karta hu sab ke sath. Koi mere ko aake bolta hai ki I'll give you dollars. That is another currency other than rupee. Can I say wo mujhe kahin na kahin jaake bechni padegi? I will have to dispose of that rupee to come back to my currency. Right? And can I say supposing the transaction we entered at the rate of say 50. $1 he gave me against 50 rupees. Barabar 50 rupees ka saman leke ke 1 dollar diya. Kya guarantee hai dusre wala banda bhi mujhe 50 dega? Can I say I am left now with an exposure that I have to dispose of this $1 and obtain my INR 50? Now can I say when I go to dispose it of, three possibilities are there. I get 50, I get more than 50, or I get less than 50. That is nothing but my exposure. And to overcome this exposure, ahead in this chapter we will see various hedging strategies, right? So sabse pehle to ye sab abhi bhul jate hai ki bhai itna itna exposure se ye hai wo hai. Let us now see what a normal foreign exchange currency quote looks like, right? Normally the question will give you $1 is equal to rupees 55.45/56.25. ये रेट सपोज दिया हुआ है. कैन आई से ही इज टेलिंग दैट फॉर $1 द रेट इज रूपी 55.45 एंड रूपी 56.25. मतलब कैन आई से दिस इज नथिंग बट रूपीज पर डॉलर, राइट? कैन आई से आई कैन रिप्रेजेंट दिस एज रूपी पर डॉलर, राइट? ये चीज समझ लो, इट इज रुपीज पर डॉलर. मतलब किस चीज की वैल्यूएशन दी हुई है मुझे? कैन आई से आई एम टोल्ड अ वैल्यूएशन फॉर डॉलर्स is equivalent to these many rupees. So we say that this particular rate given to us is a dollar rate. मतलब जो भी टर्म तुम पर के बाद लिखते हो एक्स वाई जेड पर ए दैट मींस इट इज अ ए रेट ए का कोट फॉर एवरी यूनिट ऑफ एक्स वाई जेड एम आई क्लियर ये बात समझा रुपी पर डॉलर वाला देन आई विल गो अहेड नाउ टेल मी यू आर अ पर्सन हु इज अ सेलर तो तुम ये रेट तुम कितने रुपीज मैं सेल करेगा यू आर अ से सपोजिंग एन ऑथोराइज्ड डीलर ऑफ फॉरेन एक्सचेंज राइट यू वांट टू सेल डॉलर समवन कम्स टू यू टू बाय डॉलर तुम कितने में बेचेगा कैन आई से यू विल सेल इट टू द थर्ड पार्टी एट 56.25 हायर रेट एंड कैन आई से यू विल बाय इट एट अ लोअर रेट दैट इज 55.45 राइट सो फॉर एन ऑथोराइज डीलर और अ पर्सन हु गिव्स अ फॉरेन एक्सचेंज कोट द कोट्स आर रिप्रेजेंटेड एज बिड रेट एंड आस्क रेट बिड रेट इज द व्हाट रेट कैन आई से बाइंग रेट ऑफ द बैंक एंड कैन आई से आस्क रेट इज The selling rate of the bank, right? Can I say bank will buy at 55.45 from outsiders and it will sell at 56.25, right? Now similarly, ये अपनी bank थी, right? Can I say a person had approached, right? This person wanted to buy, so can I say bank wanted to sell, right? So can I say the transaction was entered at 56.25, right? Similarly, a person comes, he wants to sell the dollars. So can I say for the bank it is equal to buy and in that case the transaction will be entered at 55.45, right? So in this chapter, can I say the bank buy rate is nothing but from the customer's point of view. It is nothing but the sell rate. And can I say the bank sell rate is nothing but the buying rate from the customer's point of view? Right? Now, whenever we will be doing this chapter, the selection of the rate that we will make will always be from the customer's point of view. Hum bank point of view se analysis karenge hi nahi. Humko kabhi bhi rate select karna hai, exchange karna hai, kuch bhi. We will always see the rate from the customer's point of view, right? Now, can I say ye dono rates mein sir ek disparity hai? The difference between these two rates, right? He is buying at 56.25 from the bank and he is selling it at 55.45 to the bank. Or can I say the bank is buying at 55.45 and selling at 56.25, right? The difference is nothing but the spread. Which is the dealers, that is in our case the bank's profit. And can I say that will always be positive? Matlab, can I say the ask rate or can I say the customer buy rate will always be greater than the bid rate or the customer sell rate? Right? Samjha ye baat. Barabar. Now sir, you told in this example that a person came to a bank. Is it possible that two banks may exchange quotes with each other or they may enter into forex transaction? Yes, very much possible. Bank of America supposing and SBI supposing may enter into foreign exchange transactions with each other. In this case, one of the other banks will be the customer and one bank will be the dealer. Suppose SBI ko dollar side wanted to get rupees. So can I say it would go to sell dollars to Bank of America and can I say Bank of America to buy dollars? In this case, can I say he is nothing but the dealer, Bank of America, and can I say in this case SBI is nothing but the customer, right? So two banks ke beech mein bhi foreign exchange transactions ho sakte. It is not necessary that one has to be the bank and the other has to be some other party. Nahin, two banks ke beech mein you can have foreign exchange transactions as such. Am I clear? Now, Let us say we'll take the same example of the rate above. Rupee per dollar 55.45/56.25. We established that we are given the currency rate of dollars. Right? Can I say this was established by us to be the dollar rate? Right? But from this transaction, supposing I want to find the rupee rate, so how do I do that? Rupee rate kaisa dhundne ka? Can I say this is nothing but dollar per rupee? The rate that I'll need, right? Because can I say per dollar meant the dollar rate. So can I say if I want rupee rate, then it has to be per rupee. Matlab can I say dollar idhar jana chahiye? Matlab can I say I'm now doing ulta things, or can I say in other words I'm now intending to take inverses, right? So the inverse rate will be rate for dollar per rupee will be equal to 1 upon rupee per dollar. I'm taking customer point of view. This is the sell rate and this is the buy rate. This will be 1 upon rupee per dollar buy / 1 upon rupee per dollar sell rate. Can I say 1 upon rupee per dollar is nothing but dollar per rupee? 1 upon 2 by 5, can I say this is nothing but 1 into 5 by 2, which is equal to 5 by 2, right? So can I say 1 upon rupee per dollar is equal to nothing but 1 up into dollar per rupee, which gives me the dollar per rupee rate, right? So can I say I now take the inverse, so can I say it will be equal to 1 upon 56.25/ 1 upon 55.45. Upon 56.25, can I say this comes to 0.01778 and 1 divided by 55.45, which is equal to 0.01803. Right? Can I say the sell rate was always lower than the buy rate? Right? And hence we proved it. Inverse leke. Right? Now, sir, how do we select the rate in the question? Rate select kaise karne ka? Look at the currency that is there in your hand. That is there in your hands. Right? Let us take one example. You are an Indian firm. You have dollars 1 lakhs in your hand, right? In your hand. Matlab, can I say you want to now get away or dispose of this 1 lakh dollars? And I'll say the rupee per dollar rate given to me is 57.35/58.20. This is the rate given to me. So can I say for the customer, this is a dollar rate, this is the sell rate, and this is the buy rate for dollars. Dollar I will sell at this and I will buy at this rate. Right? Look at the currency that is there in your hands. Can I say the currency that I have in my hands is nothing but dollars? Right? I have dollars in hand. So can I say what I want to do is get rid of dollars and get rupee. Matlab, can I say I need to do nothing but sell dollars, or in other words, can I say buy rupees, right? Sell dollars or buy rupees, right? Now second thing, look at the currency that is given to you in your hand. Second step that we have is look at the rate given to us. Can I say the rate given to us in this question is a dollar rate, right? Can I say I have dollars in my hand and I want to sell my dollars and I have been given a dollar rate, right? So can I say what I will now do is convert, right? So can I say what I will now do is dollar 1 lakh into rupee per dollar. Can I say I establish that I want to sell them, so the rate applicable to me will be 57.35. Can I say this is equal to 1 lakh into 57.35, which makes it 57,35,000 rupees. Right, because can I say dollar cancel and I get rupees in my hand, right? Barabar. This was the case when a dollar rate was given to me and I had a dollar exposure in my hand, right? Now let me just change this example to the second case. Instead of dollars, I have rupees 60 lakhs in my hand. And I have to make a payment in dollars to somebody, right? So can I say now what the case is in my hand is, can I say I have rupees in hand, right? So can I say my strategy will be get rid of rupee to get dollars, right? So can I say now my transaction will be either to sell rupees or to buy the dollars. Right? Barabar. Now look at the rate given to us in the question. Can I say the rate given to us in the question is a dollar rate? But mere haath mein kaun sa currency? Can I say I have rupees and what is given to me is of dollars? So can I compare rupees and dollars? No. Can I say it is like comparing apples to oranges? So can I say agar dollar rate diya and haath mein rupees hai, meri currency jo mere haath mein hai, can I say I need that rate? So can I say I now need the required rupee rate, right? Can I say I had to do what? Sell rupees, right? But can I say selling rupees is equivalent to buying dollars, right? So now when I am given a dollar rate, when the currency in my hand is rupees, I will do buy dollars at the dollar buy rate of 58.20, right? But can I say, we are talking something that is different from what would be the normal norm of rupees, right? Rupees haath mein nahi hai, haath mein kya hai? Rupees. But rate kiska hai? Dollars ka. Can I say we are talking in a different rate? So can I say we will have to take inverse. So can I say now it will become rupees 60 lakhs into dollar per rupees. Can I say I had told the buy dollar rate? So it will be 58.20. But since I am talking of a different currency and a different rate, it will be 1 upon. So can I say it will be 60 lakhs divided by 58.2, which is equal to dollars 1,03,092.78. This is what I will get in my hands to make the payment as such. Chalo, agar main required dollar rate, if I would have computed the required rupee rate, can I say it would have been 1/58.20/1/57.35. Can I say in the rupee rate this would have been sell, this would have been buy, and can I say now in this rate I have rupees in my hand, I have the rupee rate, so can I say my strategy will be to sell rupees, therefore the rate will be 1/58.20, and can I say I would have then multiplied by 1/58.20. Wahi to maine without inverse bhi kiya, right? Look at the currency in your hand. Look at the rate given to you in the question. If it is same, then you directly take the sell or the buy. If it is different, matlab currency is rupees but the rate is of dollars, then we take the opposite strategy that we would have taken had we been given the rupee rate. Matlab agar sell rupee pe tha main, toh main abhi buy dollars karunga. Understood? I will take the dollar rate and then I will convert. Agar mere ko same currency, same rate ra, multiply. Same currency, opposite rate, divide. Am I clear with this part of our discussion of rates? Right? Bid, ask, spread, clear hai? Now we go to the concept of arbitrage. आर्बिट्राज का मतलब क्या होता है सर? कैन आई से आर्बिट्राज इज नथिंग बट अ प्रोसेस ऑफ मेकिंग प्रॉफिट्स विच आर रिस्कलेस इन नेचर वेयर द प्रॉफिट्स आर मेड ऑन अकाउंट ऑफ डिफरेंसेस इन प्राइसेस इन टू मार्केट्स. सर नहीं समझा. ऑरेंजेस का प्राइस इन मार्केट ए एंड मार्केट बी. मार्केट ए वाला क्या बोलता है? आई विल ही टेल्स दैट फॉर द कस्टमर इफ कस्टमर सेल्स टू मी देन आई विल गिव हिम 50 रुपीज पर केजी. बट इफ अ कस्टमर वॉन्ट्स टू बाय ऑरेंजेस फ्रॉम मी आई विल सेल इट टू हिम एट 55 पर केजी. मार्केट बी वाला क्या बोलता है? इफ अ कस्टमर सेल्स टू मी आई विल सेल इट टू हिम एट 52.00 एंड इफ अ कस्टमर वॉन्ट्स टू बाय फ्रॉम मी आई विल 52 नहीं ही टेल्स दैट अ कस्टमर कैन सेल टू मी एट 49 एंड आई विल बाय फ्रॉम द कस्टमर एट से 51 राइट. सो कैन आई से यू आर कस्टमर यू वॉन्ट टू मेक अ गेन आउट ऑफ द डिफरेंसेज इन प्राइसिंग. सो वॉट आर द टू केसेस? कैन आई से बाय इन ए सेल इन बी और कैन आई से इट विल बी बाय इन बी एंड सेल इन ए राइट. इफ आई बाय इन ए कैन आई से आई एम बाइंग एट 55 एंड सेलिंग एट 49 लॉस नहीं करने वाला मैं. सेकेंड थिंग इज आई कैन डू इज बाय इन बी एंड सेल इन ए राइट. Can I say I will buy at 51, sell at 50? Again a loss. You are equal to rupee 6 and you are equal to rupee 1. So can I say whatever route I followed at this pricing will give me a loss? Right? This is nothing but the second rule of arbitrage. Apna first rule is there are only two paths. Can I say path 1, path 2? The second rule is both paths can show profits, can show losses, right? ये केस हो गया बराबर. Now supposing I tell the rate is quoted as this, I change 50 to 53. वो बोलते हैं मैं 53 में खरीदेगा एंड बेचेगा. Now in the second case, can I say if I buy in A and sell in B, I'm still making a loss of 6, right? But can I say in this route, if I buy from B at 51, I can sell it to A at 53, right? So can I say here I am having a profit of rupees 2 per kg, right? So this is nothing but our third rule of arbitrage, which says one path can show profit and one can show losses, right? But tell me one thing, even if I change this rate to say 54, right? Can I say the customer sell rate always is lower than the customer buy rate? राइट मतलब मैं कुछ भी झोल झपाटा कर दू मेरे को दोनों जगह पे तो प्रॉफिट नहीं मिलने वाला. इसमें देख लो कहना से योर आई एम स्टिल एट अ 2 रुपी प्रॉफिट बट योर आई एम एट अ 5 रुपी लॉस राइट. मतलब कहना है से द लास्ट रूल ऑफ आर्बिट्राज इज बोथ पाथ्स कैन नेवर शो प्रॉफिट्स राइट. सो दीज आर बेसिकली आवर 4 रूल्स टू arbitrage applicable in any possible arbitrage in any chapter as derivatives of forex or kuch bhi ho right. Understood? Now in this chapter what we recently discussed abhi jo arbitrage discuss kiya na usko bolte hai two way arbitrage. An arbitrage where two currencies are involved and two banks or dealers are involved or quotes are available right. So now apna example kya tha Can I say it was rupee per dollar? 52 sell buy from bank A, and from bank B, can I say the rate was rupee per dollar 48 49, right? Can I say now what do we have to do to guess whether we will have arbitrage profit or not? मतलब दिस इज अ ट्रिक टू नो कि इन दिस सम वेदर एनी पाथ विल हैव आर्बिट्रेज प्रॉफिट या दोनों पे लॉस होएगा. सो पहले तो पाथ लिख देते. कैन आई से बाय इन ए सेल इन बी, और कैन आई से इट विल बी बाय इन बी सेल इन ए, राइट? बराबर. नाउ ड्रॉ अ नंबर लाइन. एक नंबर लाइन बनाने का ऐसे. Take the first rate. What is the first rate given to you? 50 and 52. So plot this on the number line. Can I say 50, 52 aise dikhega? So can I say this is the range covered by 50 and 52? Right. Now, if the next rate given to you and that to both the quotes, that is sell and buy, both fall either to the left of 52 or if to the right of 52, then you will have arbitrage profit. Sir, nahi samjha. In this case, can I say the second rate given to me is 48, 49, right? But can I say both of them are to the left of 50? Matlab nothing is falling within this range, right? So in this case, I am going to have a profit of 1 rupee. Sir, कैसे? Can I say it will be this strategy? I buy at 49 and sell at 50. Can I say it is nothing but this range? Right? बराबर. Suppose ये change करके I make it 51. Can I say it will now be something like this? The rate will look something like this. 48 and 51. In this case, I am not able to make any profit. I will either buy at 52, sell at 48, make a loss. Or I will buy at 51, sell at 50, make a loss again. So I will not be able to make any arbitrage profit on any path. So can I say if the second quote comes within the range of the first quote, then no arbitrage possibility of profit. But if it is entirely to the left or entirely to the right of one quote, the second quote, then can I say we will have arbitrage profit. Right? Barabar. Now, let us change the example as such. 50-52 का bank 1 ने code दिया था, इधर कर देते हैं 52.5053. Can I say it will look like something 52.5053? Both are to the right. Can I say my profit now will be this 2.50? And can I say the strategy will be buy in bank A and sell in bank B? Right? क्योंकि second path पे तो वैसे भी loss है. An arbitrage ka rule hai. Both will never show profits. Only one will show profit. Right? So just remember, in two-way arbitrage, if the second quote is either entirely to the left or entirely to the right of the first quote, then you will have arbitrage profit. Varna profit nahi hoega. And can I say, usse tumko path bhi pata chal gaya, kaun se path pe profit hai. Right? So in the exams, the thing that you can do is, suppose you do the first path. Ye case mein kya tha apna? Buy in A and sell in B, right? Here you got a profit. Second path aisa likh dene ka, buy in B and sell in A. Since path 1 has already shown us a profit, we have not done calculations on path 2. For this path, as it would give us arbitrage losses. Clear? Understood? Fair enough? Now, the next type of arbitrage that we have in this question, can I say, abhi to do currency ki baat kar rahe the. Now we will talk of three currencies. Triangular arbitrage. In this case, three currencies are available, but the rules still remain the same. क्या थे अपने rules? Can I say two paths, both losses? Yes. Both profit? Never. One loss, one profit? Yes. Are we clear? So now, sir, how do we go about a sum of triangular arbitrage as such? हमको ये sum solve करने का कैसे? You will be given three currencies in the question, either through three currency codes given to you or any other similar pattern where they will give you a hint कि भाई ये triangular arbitrage करना है तुमको. So best example will be supposing they give me rates like this. रुपी पर डॉलर रेट दे दिया एक मेरे को, बराबर? डॉलर पर जीबीपी का रेट दे दिया मेरे को उन्होंने, राइट? डॉलर पर जीबीपी भी आ गया, बराबर? एंड देन दे गिव मी द रेट ऑफ रुपी पर जीबीपी, ग्रेट ब्रिटेन पाउंड. मैं जीबीपी नहीं लिखता हूं, मैं उसको पाउंड ही लिखता हूं, राइट? सपोजिंग दे हैव गिवन मी दीज थ्री रेट्स, राइट? कैन आई, एंड देन दे टेल मी यू हैव से डॉलर्स 1 lakh. शो आर्बिट्राज. कैन आई से अपना आर्बिट्राज में द फंडा वॉज वेरी क्लियर दैट वी कम बैक टू आवर करेंसी वेर वी आर. मतलब कहने से हम शुरू भी डॉलर से करेंगे और खत्म भी डॉलर पे करेंगे. वी विल हैव टू कम बैक टू डॉलर ओनली बिकॉज वी डोंट वॉन्ट एनी फॉरेन एक्सचेंज एक्सपोजर, राइट? एंड कैन आई से वेन वी एंड अप विथ मोर देन 1 lakh dollar इन द प्रोसेस वी हैव मेड प्रॉफिट, right? If we have more money than we start with, can I say we have profits? And can I say if we have less money than we start with, then we have losses, right? So can I say my journey in this question will start from dollars and it will end at dollars, right? So main kya kar sakta hu? Can I say I can go from dollar to rupee and then from rupee to pound and come back to dollars? या तो कहना है आई विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम डॉलर्स एंड एट डॉलर्स, बट डॉलर से पहले मैं पाउंड पे जाऊंगा और पाउंड को रुपीस में कन्वर्ट करूंगा, राइट? मतलब कहना है इसे दीज आर द ओनली टू पॉसिबल पाथ फॉर मी इन दिस पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन ऑल्सो ऑफ आर्बिट्राज. सो कैन आई से द फर्स्ट रूल ऑफ आर्बिट्राज दैट वी हैव ओनली टू पाथ स्टिल प्रिवेल्स, राइट? नाउ कैन आई से मेरे को रुपी पर डॉलर रेट दिया हुआ है, डॉलर पर पाउंड रेट दिया हुआ है, रुपी पर पाउंड रेट दिया हुआ है. From this data, can I say I am in a position to calculate even a theoretical rate? Right? बराबर, theoretical rate ढूंढने के मैं position में हूं. This I am doing just to see whether we have any arbitrage opportunity or not. बराबर, suppose I am given rupee per dollar 50, dollars per pound 1.45. And rupees per pound, supposing they have given me, is 85.00, right? Can I say I am in a position to calculate two theoretical rates? Can I say rupee per pound dhoond sakta hu main? And rupee per pound dealer quote is given to me. I am in a position to find the rupee per pound theoretical rate, right? Similarly, can I say I am also in a position to calculate any other rate? Like sir what? Rupee per pound, rupee per dollar तो दिया हुआ है मेरे को, but can I say I can find out the rupee per dollar theoretical rate also? Rupee per pound theoretical rate मैं कैसे ढूंढूंगा? Can I say it is nothing but rupee per dollar 50 into dollar per pound, क्योंकि मेरे को dollar numerator denominator cancel करना पड़ेगा. So can I say dollar per pound 1.45? So can I say I get रूपी पर पाउंड 50 इंटू 1.45 विच कम्स टू 72.50, राइट? कैन आई से दिस इज 72.50 थियोरेटिकली? मतलब इफ नो आर्बिट्राज वॉज टू प्रीवेल एंड दीज टू रेट्स वर टू रिमेन कॉन्स्टेंट, देन बेस्ड ऑन दीज टू रेट्स द थर्ड रेट शुड हैव बीन 72.50, बट कैन आई से एक्चुअली इट इज 85. मतलब कैन आई से थियोरेटिकल इज नॉट इक्वल टू एक्चुअल. Therefore, I can say arbitrage in this case is possible. And then I will arbitrage on any one of the path. Chalo, ye rate nahi dhunda tumne, you found out the rupee per dollar rate. Can I say it will be nothing but rupee per pound into pound by dollars. Right, rupee per pound is given to me as 85. But can I say I am given dollars per pound and not pounds per dollar? So can I say mere ko ulta lena padega? Divide. So can I say now it will be 85 upon 1.45, which is equal to rupee per dollar 58.6207. Right? Matlab, can I say if these two rates were to prevail and based on this, if a third rate was to prevail where I am not in a position to make any riskless profit, then the rate I should have been 58.6207. But can I say actually it is 50? Can I say this is not again equal to actual? Theoretical, not again equal to actual. Hence, can I say again arbitrage is possible, right? So in this case, arbitrage is always possible. So usme hum kya karenge? Buy underpriced currency and then sell overpriced currency. Samjha? Let's move ahead now. Abhi sir, next concept kya hai isme? The next concept is a relatively very easy concept. That is your commission buy and sell commission. Sir, ye kya hota hai? Normally when you go to buy any foreign exchange, bank tumko exchange rate to degi, but they also charge commission. So can I say what we will be required to do is calculate nothing but the effective sell rate or buy rate for the customer. Right. Barabar. Right. Humne kya bola tha? Bank buy is equal to, can I say customer sell? And can I say bank sell is equal to customer buy. Right. Now, whenever the commission will be given to us in the question, it will always be the bank buy commission and the bank sell commission. Matlab, can I say bank buy matlab bid rate and can I say bank sell matlab the ask rate. Right. Yeah, they will tell us the buying commission or the selling commission. Right. Supposing it is given rupee per dollar 50.51 bank buy commission is equal to 1%, sell commission is equal to 0.75%. So sir, humko kya karne ka? Can I say bank buy matlab customer sell and bank sell matlab can I say customer buy? Right? Can I say jab customer kharidega, commission is an additional expense on his pocket. So can I say the bank selling commission will be added to the customer buy rate? Matlab, can I say yahan par add ho jayega? And can I say when I sell, bank charges me commission. So can I say they will give me the proceeds net of commission? Matlab, can I say mere jeb mein kam paisa aayega? So can I say this will be nothing but reduced from 50. That is nothing but the sell rate. Right? So can I say, you see, from bank point, right, then make it customer point, matlab agar buy diya hua hai to sell kar denge, sell diya hua to khali buy likhenge, we will not change sides, right, and then after can I say making it to the customer point, we add what buy? Customer buy commission to customer buy rate and we reduce customer sell commission from customer sell rate. Matlab, can I say customer buy matlab bank sell and can I say customer sell matlab bank buy? Nahi samjha? Ye example dekho. क्या था रुपी पर डॉलर 50/51 बाइंग कमीशन था ऑफ द बैंक अपने लिए कौन सा रेट है सेल रेट एंड बाय रेट मतलब कहने से बैंक बाय इज इक्वल टू कस्टमर सेल, राइट? कस्टमर सेल मतलब पैसा कम आएगा कि ज्यादा आएगा, बाइंग कमीशन वॉज 1% तो लेस। बैंक सेल कमीशन मतलब कहने से कस्टमर बाय कमीशन मतलब कहने से और पैसा उसके जेब से जाएगा, तो एड 0.75%, तो कहने से इट विल बी 50 × 1%, दैट इज 5 पैसे माइनस, तो कहने से द रेट यर इज 49.50 एंड यर इट विल बी 51 + 0.75%, दैट इज 51.3825, राइट? दिस इज नथिंग बट द इफेक्टिव सेल रेट एंड द बाय रेट फॉर द कस्टमर एज सच। समझा? क्लियर? नाउ लेट्स गो टू द नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट, दैट इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ स्पॉट रेट एंड फॉरवर्ड रेट, राइट? सर क्या बोला, स्पॉट रेट एंड फॉरवर्ड रेट? स्पॉट रेट कहने से दिस इज द रेट फॉर द ट्रांजैक्शन टू बी एंटर टुडे, मतलब अगर आज मैं मार्केट में जाता हूं अभी का भी ट्रांजैक्शन करना है, देन दिस इज द स्पॉट रेट, दिस इज द रेट ऑफ द एक्सचेंज रेट विच द बैंक विल कोट टू मी टू एंटर द ट्रांजैक्शन, राइट? कहने से स्पॉट रेट इज द रेट फॉर इमीडिएट ट्रांजैक्शन, एंड बाय इमीडिएट ट्रांजैक्शन आई मीन T+2 trading days, राइट? सो इफ आई एम ड्रॉइंग द टाइम लाइन ओवर योर, कैन आई से आई एम स्टैंडिंग ओवर योर, द रेट इज ऑन दिस डेट, द ट्रांजैक्शन इज ऑल्सो ऑन दिस डेट, राइट? Right, transaction is going to be entered also on this date. So can I say this is nothing but a spot rate, right? So sir, forward rate kya hua? Forward rate is also a rate decided today. Rate decided today for the transaction to take place in future. Matlab, can I say if it is this timeline only which I have to consider, can I say the rate is of this date only? I am standing also on this date, but can I say my transaction will not be entered over here? It will be entered over here, say some this date, or at the, can I say rate which has been decided over here? So matlab, can I say ये रेट के ऊपर ट्रांजैक्शन एंटर होने वाला है ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर डेट? नाउ व्हाट एवर विद द एक्चुअल रेट ऑन दिस डेट डज नॉट मैटर, क्योंकि हमने पहले से ही डिसाइड किया हुआ है कि वी विल एंटर इनटू द ट्रांजैक्शन एट दिस रेट। अंडरस्टूड? सो कैन आई से दिस इज नथिंग बट वन ऑफ द हेजिंग स्ट्रैटेजी दैट आई डिसाइड द रेट टूडे इटसेल्फ फॉर द ट्रांजेक्शन टू बी एंटर्ड इन द फ्यूचर, बिकॉज अगर फ्यूचर में मार्केट में कुछ भी रेट हुआ, कैन आई से आई एम अनअफेक्टेड बिकॉज वी हैव ऑलरेडी अग्रीड अ रेट एट विच वी विल एंटर द ट्रांजेक्शन। इफ फ्यूचर रेट इज बेनिफिशियल टू दिस पर्सन दैट इज टू मी, सपोज मैंने एंटर किया है ट्रांजेक्शन एट रूपी पर डॉलर 51, इफ ऑन दिस डेट रूपी पर डॉलर इज 52, देन दैट पर्सन विल नॉट गिव मी 52, ही विल गिव मी 51। If it is 51 तो कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता क्योंकि स्पॉट लो फॉरवर्ड लो इट इज 51। बट इफ द रेट बिकम्स रूपी पर डॉलर 50, देन आई विल नॉट गेट 50, दिस पर्सन विल गिव मी 51 बिकॉज आई हैव एंटर्ड इन टू अ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट विथ हिम टू बाय और एंटर इन टू दैट ट्रांजेक्शन एट द रेट ऑफ रूपी पर डॉलर 52। क्लियर? फेयर इनफ? समझा? मतलब सर आपके कहने का मतलब है कि फॉरवर्ड रेट और स्पॉट रेट एक दूसरे से अलग होते हैं? Yes, they may be different and ideally they should be different, right? Because of the inflation impact, the purchasing power parity impact, the interest rates in both the markets, right? It will be different. It will, the exchange rate is nothing but a parameter of the purchasing power, inflation, interest rate and the various economic scenarios of two countries, right? So can I say wo alag hoega hi? So can I say if I have a rupee per dollar spot rate, I will also have a rupee per dollar say 2 months forward rate, right? Suppose they tell me 55 56, yeah, I take a single rate only 55 57, matlab sir iska matlab kya hua? Can I say both the rates first of all given to me are dollar rates, right? Because it is rupee per dollar, right? Now tell me sir, agar spot market mein transaction enter karte hai na, to we will get $1 against 55 rupees, मतलब आई विल हैव टू पे 55 रुपीज एंड गेट $1. बट सर अगर दो महीने के फॉरवर्ड रेट पे इफ यू एंटर द ट्रांजैक्शन देन आई विल हैव टू पे 57 रुपीज टू गेट दैट $1. मतलब कैन आई से इन द फॉरवर्ड रेट मार्केट I am having to pay 2 rupees more against that same $1. So can I say dollar has appreciated? So can I say rupee has depreciated? Right, अगर एक करेंसी बढ़ेगी तो दूसरी अपने आप कम ही होती है राइट बट कैन आई से नॉट बाय द सेम परसेंटेज बिकॉज कैन आई से द बेस एट विच आई विल कंपेयर विल नाउ बिकम डिफरेंट राइट समझा ये बात तो कैन आई से डॉलर हैज अप्रिशिएटेड बाय 2 रुपीज सो कैन आई से द डॉलर अप्रिशिएशन विल बी इक्वल टू 57 माइनस 55 अपॉन 55 इनटू 100 राइट बट कैन आई से इट वाज अ 2 मंथ फॉरवर्ड आई नीड टू एनुअलाइज इट सो इट विल बी इनटू 12 बाय 2 तो कितना आता है कैन आई से 2 डिवाइड बाय 55 इनटू 12 बाय 2 मतलब कैन आई से इट हैज बीन बाय 21.81% पर एनम सिमिलरली कैन आई से द डॉलर रुपी हैज डेप्रिशिएट तो डेप्रिशिएट कितने से है कैन आई से 57 माइनस 55 2 रुपीस बट रुपी स्टार्ट कहां से होता है 57 से इनटू 100 इनटू 12 बाय 2 So the depreciation has happened by 21.05% per annum. So can I say if it is appreciation, सबसे पहले तो, if it is which rate? Dollar rate मांगा है, दिया है, dollar appreciation या dollar depreciation ढूंढना है, तो can I say dollar rate, dollar appreciation or depreciation, the formula, or can I say in other words, डॉलर फॉरवर्ड प्रीमियम और फॉरवर्ड डिस्काउंट द फॉर्मूला विल बी एफ माइनस एस अपॉन एस इंटू 100 इंटू 12 बाई एन एंड इफ इट इज डॉलर्स गिवन टू मी और डॉलर रेट गिवन टू मी बट इफ दे आस्क मी टू फाइंड रूपी डेप्रिसिएशन और अप्रिसिएशन दैट इज कैन आई से रूपी फॉरवर्ड डिस्काउंट और फॉरवर्ड प्रीमियम देन माई फॉर्मूला बिकम्स एन उल्टा फॉर्मूला दैट आई कॉल्ड विच इज इक्वल टू एस माइनस एफ अपॉन एफ इंटू 100 इंटू 12 बाय एन मतलब ये हो जाएगा 55 माइनस 57 अपॉन 57 विच इज नेगेटिव 21.05% दिस नेगेटिव मीन्स दैट इट इज अ डिस्काउंट But when you write the answer, ऐसे लिखने का, therefore, forward discount is equal to 21.05% per annum. Because if you write forward discount is negative, can I say two negatives will mean that forward discount negative is equal to forward premium of this? And can I say वो गलत हो जाएगा? Right? तो तुमको कैलसी पे negative आएगा, which means discount. But तुम रुपी, उसको जब लिखोगे, you will write forward discount of rupee. Right? So, मतलब कहने से रेट डॉलर का अप्रिसिएशन डॉलर का एफ माइनस एस अपॉन एस इंटू 100 इंटू 12 बाय एन रेट डॉलर का बट दूसरी करेंसी का डेप्री अप्री ढूंढना है तो कहने से इट विल बी दी उल्टा रेट एस माइनस एफ अपॉन एफ इंटू 100 इंटू 12 बाय अंडरस्टूड क्लियर नाउ सर अपन कुछ फॉरवर्ड कवर की बात कर रहे थे राइट फॉरवर्ड कवर इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इजिएस्ट हेजिंग स्ट्रैटेजी दैट यू विल एवर कम अक्रॉस इन दिस पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर बट उसके पहले फॉरवर्ड रेट डिटरमाइन कैसे होता है फॉरवर्ड रेट इज नथिंग बट अ डिटरमिनेशन बेस्ड ऑन द स्वॉप्शंस और द स्वॉप पॉइंट्स दैट आर अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट विच रिफ्लेक्ट द पीरियड चेंजेस बिटवीन द टू करेंसी मतलब क्या चेंज आएगा वो डीलर डिटरमाइन किए हुए होते हैं डीलर के पास होते हैं ये स्वॉप रेट्स मतलब इन टू मंथ्स एंड दे एक्सपेक्ट द बाय रेट टू बी अप बाय समथिंग सेल रेट टू बी अप बाय समथिंग सो द डीलर विल गिव यू द स्वॉप्शंस सो कैन आई से द डिटेल्स सपोजिंग टू मी आर गिवन लाइक दिस स्पॉट रेट रूपी पर डॉलर 51.00 51.30 टू मंथ फॉरवर्ड रेट फॉरवर्ड और टू मंथ स्वॉप points are given as 0.25 0.35 3 month swap points are given to me as 0.40/0.30 right Can I say from this I am in a position to calculate the 2 month forward rate and 3 month forward rate, right? But remember, how do we make the calculation to the swap points and the spot rate to arrive at the forward rate? If the swap points are in ascending order, then we add them from the last digit of the decimal of the spot rate. Suppose ye 0.025 diya hota, so it would have been 51.025, right? And if these rates are given to us in descending order, that is niche se upar, then what we do is we subtract them from the last digit. So can I say the 2 month forward rate is equal to nothing but 51.25 / 51.65 rupees per dollar, and can I say the 3 month forward rate is equal to 50.60 / 51.00 rupees per dollars. Matlab, can I say over the period of 2 months the dollar has appreciated, which means rupee has depreciated, and can I say over the period of 3 months dollar has depreciated, therefore rupee appreciated, right? So can I say when the swap points are in ascending order, they mean to say that jis currency ka rate hai, that currency is at a premium. Can I say in this case it is a dollar rate? So can I say dollar at premium over the period of 2 months, right? And can I say when they are in descending order, it means this currency ka rate hai, that currency at a discount, therefore can I say dollar at discount? And can I say that is even visible from the two exchange rate quotations? Clear? Samjha? Now we go to forward cover. So what is basically a forward cover? Can I say a forward cover depends on a forward rate? I am covering my position today in the forward market. It means forward cover, for which I need a forward rate. And can I say forward rate is nothing but a rate that has been decided today for the transaction to take place at some point of time in the future, irrespective of what the actual rate turns out to be in the future, right? Supposing maine bola hai ki I want to enter into the transaction at rupee per dollar 50 under the forward market. Now either if it is 51 or 50 or 48 in the market on this date when I have to enter the transaction, I don't have to be bothered because our contract with the second party tells us ki humko 50 mein milega. We don't have to worry about what will happen over here. This is no longer of importance to us, right? So sir, how do we take a position in the forward market, right? Can I say you could have two possible positions? Either you have दो सिनारियो हो सकते हैं, आइदर आई हैव एफसी रिसीवेबल, फॉरेन करेंसी मिलने वाली है, या तो आई हैव फॉरेन करेंसी पेएबल. आई वांट टू हेज माय पोजीशन, मतलब आई वांट टू सेफगार्ड मायसेल्फ फ्रॉम द एक्सपोजर. सो कैन आई से अगर रिसीवेबल्स है मेरे पास, व्हाई विल आई वांट टू सेफगार्ड मायसेल्फ? बिकॉज कैन आई से आई फील और आई फियर दैट रेट इन फ्यूचर विल फॉल, right? My fear is that the rates will fall in the future. So can I say I believe that the rate today is very much higher as compared to the rate in the future, right? So can I say my strategy then will be to, can I say sell FC forward, foreign currency forward, right? This is nothing but the strategy I will take into account. Similarly, if I have foreign currency payable, can I say the fear is that in the future the rates will rise? Rate in future राइज मतलब कैन आई से आई बिलीव दैट आई विल हैव टू पे मोर इफ आई डोंट एंटर इनटू अ पोजीशन टुडे सो कैन आई से माय स्ट्रेटजी विल अकॉर्डिंगली बी टू सेफगार्ड माय सेल्फ एंड देयरफॉर कैन आई से आई विल बाय एफसी फॉरवर्ड टुडे एट द लोअर रेट बिकॉज मेरे को क्या लग रहा है फ्यूचर में भाव बढ़ेगा तो आज सस्ता है खरीद लो राइट अंडरस्टूड दिस इज नथिंग बट द स्ट्रैटेजी दैट यू टेक अंडर फॉरवर्ड कवर बराबर इफ यू आर इफ द क्वेश्चन डज नॉट से वेदर यू हैव रिसीवेबल और पेबल बट इफ द क्वेश्चन सेज यू आर एन एक्सपोर्टर फर्म मतलब कहने से एक्सपोर्टर मतलब यू हैव सेंट आउट गुड्स टू अदर्स मतलब कहने से यू विल बी रिसीविंग पेमेंट्स सो इट मीन्स दैट यू हैव एफसी रिसीवेबल इफ यू आर सपोजिंग एन इंपोर्टर फर्म कैन आई से यू हैव टेकन गुड्स फ्रॉम समवन सो नाउ यू विल हैव टू मेक दैट पेमेंट सो कैन आई से द पोजिशन दैट यू आर अंडर इज एफसी पेएबल राइट सो सर हाउ टू प्रेजेंट द आंसर इन द क्वेश्चन आंसर इन द एग्जामिनेशन फर्स्ट स्टेप डिटरमाइन एक्सपोजर दैट यू हैव होम करेंसी एंड फॉरेन करेंसी ये तीनों डिटरमाइन कर देने का द नेक्स्ट स्टेप दैट यू हैव इज टू Determine the strategy. Your third step is to select the appropriate forward rate. If I've taken sell FC forward, मतलब can I say sell the foreign currency का forward? So can I say net foreign currency rate उसका sell rate डाल के मैं डाल दूंगा, right? And then can I say my fourth step will be to hedge using the selected strategy and rate, right? Supposing I am an Indian firm, Indian exporter who has sold goods worth dollars 1 lakh, right? So can I say Indian exporter, home currency is equal to rupees, foreign currency is equal to dollar, right? Barabar, they have given me Spot is equal to rupee per dollar 60.50 2 month forward is equal to rupee per dollar 61.25 and they have given me the 2 month spot मतलब दूसरे महीने के end पे actual spot turns out to be rupee per dollar 60.70/61.15 Can I say this is nothing but the sell rate and the buy rate? And can I say all of these are nothing but dollar rates? And can I say all of these are sell foreign currency rate given to me in comparison to the dollar? Right? I am an exporter. Can I say my fear is price will fall? Therefore, can I say the strategy will be to sell FC forward? That is, can I say dollar forward? राइट मैं किस चीज की बात कर रहा हूं कहने से फॉरवर्ड सो कहने से द एप्लीकेबल रेट विल बी द टू मंथ फॉरवर्ड रेट उसमें भी आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट सेल सो कहने से 61 विल बी द एप्लीकेबल रेट राइट सो देयरफॉर प्रोसीड्स एट फॉरवर्ड रेट कैन आई से इट विल बी इक्वल टू डॉलर 1 lakh इंटू रूपी पर डॉलर 61.00 विच इज इक्वल टू रूपीज 61 lakhs receivable, right? If I would have not gone for this hedging, can I say I would have now entered the transaction at the end of the 2 months at the actual spot rate? Can I say under no hedge, rate will be the 2 month forward rate, 2 month ke end ka spot rate, right? The actual spot. And that day I would have to sell dollar, so the rate would have been 60.70. So can I say I would have proceeds equal to $1 lakh into rupee per dollar 60.70, which is equal to rupees 60,70,000 receivable, right? So in this case, can I say you would always suggest the firm to go ahead with the hedging option because you are having more amounts receivable in hedging as compared to no hedge. But now tell me, supposing this rate becomes 61.05 instead of 60.70, 61.05. Can I say this would change over here to 61.05? This would change here to 61.05, which would make it 61,05,000. Matlab, can I say you would now suggest him to not go for hedging, that is to go for no hedge because he has more receipts to the extent of rupees 5,000. So can I say you would conclude no hedge, right? But think, yaar, ye rates 2 mahine ke baad theek hoegi nahi hoegi, you never know na. It would actually turn out to be this, you don't know because decision aaj le rahe ho. So can I say I would be diplomatic in my conclusion and say no hedge gives more proceeds, but can I say it is still advisable for the firm to go ahead with the hedging option on a commercial sense? But from commercial point of view, it is advisable to go for forward hedging. No hedge, more proceeds. This will be from a financial point of view, right? If say what happens, can I say the examiner gets an idea that we understand that if you are getting more money, go for that option. But can I say the examiner will also come to know that we know the situation, na? If the money does not turn out to be as expected, we can face losses. So it is always better to safeguard the hedging position, right? Barabar. चले आगे. Under forward cover, now can I say एक ऐसा situation हो सकता है कि you may have entered into the forward contract, you may have entered into the import export, but the order is cancelled as such, right? Order cancel हो जाता है due to some reason or the other. Can I say you will now have to cancel the forward contract, right? If the order is cancelled, if you have given back the goods of import case, or if you have taken back your goods of export case, agar goods nahi hai, transaction no longer exists, can I say you will have to now cancel your forward position also, right? So the cancellation of the forward position takes place not by cancelling that contract. You take a reverse position for the balance maturity. सर नहीं समझा. सपोजिंग आई एंटर्ड इनटू अ 3 month फॉरवर्ड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट ऑन 1st Jan, कैन आई से द कॉन्ट आई एंटर इनटू अ बाय फॉरवर्ड बाय एफसी. व्हाई डिड आई बाय एन एफसी? बिकॉज आई वाज एक्सपेक्टिंग रेट्स टू राइज इन द फ्यूचर. मतलब कैन आई से आई हैड एन एफसी पेएबल पोजिशन, राइट? I have bought the forward contract, right? Supposing I bought it at rupee per dollar 50. This was the 3 month forward rate. Barabar. Now supposing if I have come to know on the same day that the contract is cancelled, I will enter into a sell 3 month FC contract. Supposing the sell rate is 49.00 rupees per dollar, right? Both contracts will mature on this date and I will have net settlement proceeds in this case because I have to sell. So matlab, can I say I will get 49 and I have bought at 50? Matlab, can I say I will have to pay 50 and I will receive 49? Matlab, can I say I will have to make a net payment of rupee 1 per dollar, right? That is my loss. Similarly, if I want to cancel the contract on 1st Feb, I will have to enter into a sell 2 month FC contract at the 2 month sell forward rate prevailing on 1 February. Similarly, अगर मुझे 1st मार्च को cancel करना है contract, it will be sell 1 month FC contract and I will sell it at the 1 month sell forward rate. And if I want to cancel the contract on this date itself, I will have to enter into a sell spot contract because it is the same day, it is the same day on which the actual transaction is maturing. So I will have to do it at the spot rate in the market. Right? क्योंकि उस दिन पे फॉरवर्ड रेट होगा नहीं, आज के तारीख में तुम थोड़ी बोलेगा कि आज का फॉरवर्ड रेट क्या है, आज तो आज हो. सो आज अगर आज हो, इफ यू आर देयर टुडे, सो टुडेज रेट इज द स्पॉट रेट, सो इट विल प्रिवेल एट दैट पर्टिकुलर रेट. एम आई क्लियर? इन एडिशन टू दिस, फॉर एवरी कैंसलेशन ऑफ वन कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, द फॉरेन एक्सचेंज डीलर्स एसोसिएशन ऑफ इंडिया चार्जेस अ फिक्स्ड फी ऑफ ₹100 पर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट. सो इफ यू हैव गॉट अ लॉस, add fair I charges, and if you get a profit on cancellation, then reduce the fair I charges of ₹100 and arrive at net receipt or payment. Understood? This is the concept of cancellation of the forward contract. Now the next concept that we have is extension of forward contract. Supposing you had sold goods to someone for a credit of 3 months. मतलब 1st जैन को तुमने बेचा, you gave him a credit of 3 months, right? You had FC receivable. Fear is rates will fall. So can I say you would have taken an FC sell position today? Right, so you entered into a FC sell 3 months, say at suppose rupee per dollar 50.00. Now supposing that person comes to you on the same day and tells you ki nahi mere ko bhai ek aur mahina extra do, can I say he will now request me for one more month ka credit period? So can I say he will give me the money on 1/5, but can I say aaj ki tarikh mein maine to contract 1/4 pe enter kar diya hai? So can I say my first step will be cancel the existing contract, right? So can I say on this date now I will enter into a buy 3 month forward contract at 3 month forward rate, and can I say now I will enter into a new contract for 4 months period, that is sell 4 month forward contract at 4 month forward rate, right? So can I say kya hoega, ye sell position or ye buy position is din pe khatam ho jayega, right? Can I say I will have net loss or net receipts over here, add or less fed I? And can I say on this date now I will receive the proceeds, that I will receive the dollar amount from that particular party, I will sell it to the bank on this date at the agreed forward rate, right? Aisa bhi ho sakta hai ki wo mere paas 1st feb ko aaye. So can I say I will cancel at 2 month forward and enter into a new contract at sell 3 month forward at the forward rate prevailing on 1/2. 1st march hoega, can I say I will now have to buy 1 month forward and then I will again enter into a sell 2 month forward contract. And agar 1/4 ki baat hai, can I say here what will happen is I will buy spot and I will also sell 1 month forward, right? If I want to enter into the forward cover, right? Matlab jo bhi rates ho, pehle to I will have to cancel the existing position and then can I say I will enter into the contract for the new position, right? So can I say the two steps of cancellation are cancel the existing position and then enter into new forward contract for the new duration, right? Am I clear? Now yaad hai cancellation pe fed I charges hote hai flat 100, वैसे ही एक्सटेंशन पे भी फिडाई चार्जेस फ्लैट rupees 100 per contract. So can I say, जब मेरा cancellation का मैं calculation करूँगा, तब I will have FDI, I will have profit or loss, and then I will have net over here. And can I say, when I will have settlement of the new contract, I will have total proceeds, FDI, and then the net proceeds. Can I say receivable position होएगा, तो can I say I will have to pay FDI charges. And अगर can I say payable position होगा, तो इस दिन पे I will have to pay FDI charges. बराबर दोनों में pay ही करना है ना. But can I say receivable होएगा, तो ये receive हो रहा है, ये pay हो रहा है, तो can I say minus. And can I say अगर ये भी payable position है, ये भी pay करना है, can I say then add. Right? Then this will give me the net proceeds as such. Are we clear with this part of cancellation and extension of forward contracts? Right. Now we go to the next concept, that is the interest rate parity theorem. So basically the interest rate parity theorem that we have says that two countries ka jo currency rate hota hai, that is reflected or that has to take into account the interest rates that are prevailing in both countries. Matlab, can I say it say that the exchange rate between the two countries is affected by the interest rate differentials. Matlab, wo kya kehna chahta hai, agar dono countries mein interest rate same hai and the exchange rate is suppose 50, then even the forward rate or the rate that will happen in the market in the future will remain same. But agar dono countries mein interest rates alag hai, then that difference has to be reflected on the exchange rates of both countries. Matlab, can I say the country which has its interest rate low as compared to the other country will have its currency at a premium. Kyunki can I say interest rate tells us that over a period of time the value of money deteriorates. Matlab, jo country kam interest deti hai, can I say wo apni value bacha ke rakhti hai, that country keeps its value intact or makes best possible efforts to have least depreciation on their currency as compared to the other currency. That is why we say that the country whose interest rate is lower has its currency at a premium as such. Let's look at this example. Consider a situation where the interest rate in India happens to be 10% and the interest rate in US happens to be 4% respectively. I can say from this step itself that the US dollar is at a premium to the Indian rupee. Right? The spot rate is rupee per dollar 60. Matlab, can I say rupees hai or dollars hai? Okay. Suppose we have to borrow dollar 100 for 1 year in the US. Can I say after 1 year the payment will be $1,000 add 4% interest, that is $1,040. Right? Can I say I have borrowed dollars? Matlab, can I say I will invest the dollars in my country in rupees? I will convert them to rupees sabse pehle at the spot rate. So can I say if the dollar aaya or spot rate convert hua? Right? Can I say I will get 60,000 rupees now? And can I say I will invest 60,000 rupees at 10% per annum? So at the end of the year when I have to make the payment, can I say I will have rupees 66,000, right? And can I say I have to make a payment of $1,040? So this theory states that the exchange rate, to avoid any arbitrage possibility or to avoid the possibility of any person to gain from the interest rate differentials, should make the interest rate after 1 year equal to rupee per dollar 66,000 upon 1040, which is equal to 63.4615. And then I will not have any arbitrage possibility. So can I say maine kya kiya? One, I took the spot rate, right? Spot rate liya. Usme can I say I added the interest rate of rupees and removed the interest rate of dollars. Can I say into 1 plus I into 1 plus IB, right? So remember, this is nothing but the IRP equation where I is nothing but the interest rate of rupees and IB is nothing but the interest rate of dollars in a rupee per dollar rate. If you give me a dollar per rupee rate, then IA will be dollars and IB will be rupees. Depends on what rate is given to me. IA will be the before per wala, IB is this. Understood? In case of a rupee dollar rate, IA means the rupee interest rate and IB means the dollar interest rate. Understood? Now, sir, agar ye alag hua to, can it never be different? Nahi, alag ho sakta na, kyun alag nahi hoega? Alag ho sakta, actually the rate may be different. Can I say if it is different, arbitrage is possible? Right? So the next concept that we have under this IRP theory is nothing but the arbitrage theory. Arbitrage kaise karne ka isme? Sabse pehle to, can I say I will borrow some amount and calculate the amount payable at maturity? Right? Supposing I am given rupee interest rate is equal to 10%, dollar interest rate is equal to 4%. Barabar, I am told rupee per dollar spot is equal to rupees 60 is equal to 60.00. Right? And I am given, what else do I need? Spot rate today. And can I say, after 1 year, rupee per dollar is equal to 62.00. Arbitrage. Can I say the rule is again of two paths? Can I say the first path is, borrow dollars and invest? And can I say the second path is, borrow rupee and invest? Right? Now I go to the first path, borrow dollars and invest. So can I say I have borrowed, supposing I borrow dollar 10,000 at 4% per annum. Therefore, can I say amount payable at maturity? Can I say it is equal to dollars 10,000 into 1.04? Can I say dollars 10,400 I have to pay? Right? Dollar pay itna mere ko karna hai. Can I say I receive the dollars, I will convert dollars to rupees. To rupees today. And can I say when I use the word today, it becomes the spot rate. So can I say rupee received will be, can I say dollars 10,000 into rupee per dollar 60.00. Can I say it is equal to rupees 6 lakhs. Right. Now can I say rupees mil gaya, so I will invest. Right. Invest at 10% per annum for 1 year. So can I say amount receivable at maturity will be equal to, can I say 6 lakh rupees into 1.10, which is equal to rupees 6,60,000. Right? Barabar. Now, can I say, ye to rupees ki baat ho gayi, but I am paying dollars 10,400. If I get more amount than dollar 10,400, then I have made profit or else I make losses. Right? So can I say the fourth step will be to convert rupee 6,60,000 to dollars at, can I say rupee per dollar 62.00, that is the 1 year ke baad wala rate, kyunki us din I will get the money, that is the forward rate which I will enter into the contract with. So can I say therefore dollar receivable will be equal to, can I say rupee 6,60,000 hai, right? I need the rupee rate, but they have given me what rate? Dollar rate. So can I say ulta, inverse 1/62.00. So kitna aata hai? Can I say I get 6,60,000 divided by 62, that is equal to dollars 10,645.16. Right? This day I get dollars. I will have to make the payment of $10,400. Therefore, can I say profit is equal to dollars 245.16. This is the profit. Now I don't need to do the second path where I will borrow rupees. If I end up with more funds than the currency, or I end up with more funds than I start with, then I always make profits, right? मतलब कहना इसे मैंने आर्बिट्राज का पाथ कहां से शुरू किया, आई बोरोड द करेंसी विच इज एट अ प्रीमियम. सो आर्बिट्राज अंडर दिस मेथड नॉर्मली गिव्स प्रॉफिट्स, और द पाथ दैट नॉर्मली गिव्स प्रॉफिट्स इज द वन वे यू बोरो फंड्स ऑफ द करेंसी विच इज एट अ प्रीमियम and invest them and invest those funds in the currency which is at a discount. मतलब can I say borrow funds of the currency which is at a premium, that is can I say low interest rate, and invest in the fund which is at a discount, that is can I say high interest rate. This normally gives the path of profit, but not necessarily will always give the path of profit. Understood? Majority case में इसी path में profit आता है, but at times arbitrage का rule है ना, both paths can show losses, so both can show you losses. Possibility of both losses is also there. Don't feel that ऐसा कोई possibility नहीं होता sir. Understood? Now arbitrage की भी बात हो गई, अब IRP में hedging की बात करते हैं, interest rate parity में. Can I say till now we hedged using the forward cover, और forward rate में हम लोग क्या लेते थे, the forward rate. But can I say IRP क्या बोलता है, the forward rate is nothing but the spot rate into the interest rate differentials of both the currencies, right? So can I say if I have the spot rate, I have the interest rate in both the currencies, I can hedge even using that particular mechanism. मतलब instead of using the forward rate, now can I say I will use the spot rate, the interest rate in one country and the interest rate in the other country, right? This type of hedging under IRP is particularly or very famously known as money market cover. इसको money market cover के नाम से जाना जाता है. Understood? तो money market cover में क्या होता है, can I say our first step is to cut whatever exposure we have. वही चीज हम लोग forward में भी करते थे कि if we had a receivable position, we used to fear that, तो हम क्या कर देते थे, sell, ताकि payable position में आ जाए indirectly. So right, the first step similarly in money market cover or MMC is nothing but to cut your exposure. मतलब if I have receivables, so how do I cut a receivable position? By can I say making a payable position. If I have to receive something and if I have to pay something, can I say my exposure is cut? And can I say when that exposure is cut, I am safe from my position, right? So मेरे को अभी payable position create करना है to cut my receivable exposure. Payable position create करने के लिए can I say I will have to buy or borrow something, right? So can I say my first step will be to borrow the funds today. I will borrow the funds today. So can I say I'll borrow कर दूंगा तो उनको अपनी home currency में convert कर दूंगा. तो can I say I will sell the borrowed funds, right? I sold the borrowed funds and got my home currency. Can I say now what I will do is I will invest my home currency for the balance period and receive that at the end. So can I say under FC receivable, the fear or the step that I will do is cut the exposure, so make FC payable. And FC payable banane ke steps kya hai? The strategy that I will involve is borrow, sell, invest, right? We have FC receivable, we have to cut the exposure for which we need to make a payable position, thus borrow. Once we borrow, we shall have foreign currency in our hand which we shall sell and buy the home currency which will be invested to get home currency at the due date. Similarly, if I have foreign currency payable, can I say I need to cut the exposure, so I need to make a receivable position, right? Receivable position कैसे होगा, मैंने कुछ invest किया होगा तो उसके लिए receive होगा मेरे को. If I invest today, then I will receive at the end. But can I say for investment I need to buy that money today, and can I say when I need to buy करने के लिए I need to borrow, right? So my strategy under FC payable is invest, buy, borrow to create an FC receivable position, right? We have FC payable, we have to cut the exposure for which we need to take a receivable position, thus invest. To invest, we will have to buy FC, right, through foreign currency, and we will have to buy foreign currency through home currency. And for that purpose, can I say I will have to go to the bank today and take a home currency loan so that he can have money in my hands, right? This is nothing but the step of FC payable money market cover. Are we clear? Right. Ek sum dekhte chota wala. I will not go into the forward cover and all of that. We will only do money market cover in this question. Are we clear? Right. So now let's go to that question over here. This firm has 50,000 pounds payable after 3 months. The spot rate is dollar per pound 1.6210, 1.6250. The 3 months forward rate is dollar per pound 1.6280 and 1.6350. Can I say both the rates, either the spot or the forward, both of them, can I say are nothing but pound rates? And what will I have in my hands as payable? Can I say pounds? Clear itna? Okay, the 3 month interest rate on dollars is 6%, 7% and pound is 4%/5%. So can I say if I want to borrow funds as a customer from the bank, can I say they will give me the funds at 7% and 5%? Right? Can I say two of these are nothing but the borrowing rate from customer's point of view? Right, and similarly, can I say if the bank is giving me interest on my deposits or accepting deposits from me, can I say for that purpose the dollar deposit rate and the pound deposit rate is 6% and 4% per annum respectively? So can I say both these rates are nothing but deposit rate for the customer? Right, advise the US firm regarding the forward cover or money market cover decision. Right. Let's start with this particular question as such. The given firm is a US firm. Right. Can I say for a US firm the home currency is nothing but dollars and the foreign currency based on this question is pounds. Right. Right. This company has, or this US firm has pounds 50,000 payable after 3 months. Can I say the position that is there is payable? Therefore, can I say under money market cover, the strategy will be to first of all cut the exposure, right? Therefore, enter into FC receivable position so that after this tenor of 3 months I have receivables in my hand which I will use to set off this payable. Right, so can I say therefore my strategy will be to invest. I will have to buy the funds, and for buying the funds, can I say I will have to borrow home currency? Right, understood. So can I say my first step will be invest? So can I say what I need is, I need to invest pounds today to, can I say, receive pound 50,000 after 3 months. Right? Can I say I need to invest the pounds today to receive 50,000 pounds after 3 months because that is my standing exposure which I have to cut off on the end of 3 months. Right. So can I say relevant rate in this case for me, that is the relevant interest rate, can I say is equal to the pound deposit rate? And can I say that pound deposit rate for me is nothing but 4% per annum? Right. Therefore, can I say it is equal to 1% for 3 months? Right. So, can I say the amount that I will receive after 3 months should be 50,000 including interest? So, can I say funds required for investment? Therefore, pounds required to be invested if pound 50,000 is equal to 1.01, because I have to incorporate that interest, then can I say the principal component is what? can I say it is equal to 50,000 divided by 1.01, which is equal to pounds 49,504.95. Right? Can I say these are the pounds that I will have to invest today? But can I say to invest, I first of all need to buy these pounds, na? Right? So can I say my next step will be to buy pounds 49,504.95 today at, can I say, dollar per pound spot rate. Can I say spot rate will come into picture because the borrowing is happening today, right? Barabar. I have to buy what? Can I say pounds? Rate given to me, can I say is pound rate in the question? Sir, कैसे पता? जब question starting में discuss किया तभी बोला ना? So, in this case, can I say the relevant rate is equal to spot dollar per pound 1.6210/1.6250. And can I say from the customer's point of view, this is the sell rate and this is the buy rate. Right? Samjha? So can I say I have therefore required dollars to buy pounds? Can I say the currency that I need or what is in my hand is pounds? Can I say the rate given to me is a pound rate? Right? What do I have to do? Can I say buy pounds? So can I say my relevant rate is 1.6250 into 1.6250. Can I say the amount of dollars that I will require, can I say is equal to dollars 80,445.54. Right? But can I say I have to borrow these dollars now from the market because I have to invest these many dollars to buy the pound which will be invested for 3 months. Right? So can I say my last and final step will be to borrow dollars 80,445.54 today for 3 months. Right? 3 महीने के लिए क्यों सर हम लोग borrow कर रहे हैं? कोई बता सकता है why we borrow only for 3 months? Can I say at the end of 3 months I will be getting back the amount? राइट right. 3 महीने के एंड पे मेरे को एक पेएबल पोजीशन क्रिएट करना था और एक रिसीवेबल पोजीशन क्रिएट किया मैंने. राइट? कैन आई से दो 50,000 विल सेट ऑफ अगेंस्ट ईच अदर. बट कैन आई से क्योंकि मैंने डे वन पे ये पूरा ट्रांजैक्शन एंटर कर दिया है इनटू डॉलर्स, कैन आई से द नेट अमाउंट पेएबल फॉर मी अंडर डॉलर्स इज नथिंग बट व्हाट आई एम बोरोइंग टुडे प्लस दैट इंटरेस्ट विच आई हैव टू पे फॉर द पीरियड ऑफ 3 मंथ. राइट? मतलब कैन आई से दिस इज नथिंग बट माई पाउंड लायबिलिटी एंटायरली कन्वर्टेड इंटू डॉलर्स. Right? So can I say in this case the relevant interest rate, can I say it will be the dollar borrowing rate? Can I say the dollar borrowing rate is 7% per annum? Can I say this is nothing but 1.75% for 3 months? Right? Samjha itna? Therefore, can I say dollars payable on maturity? Can I say it is equal to dollars 80,445.54 into 1.75. 1.0175. Right? 1.017. Can I say the dollars payable to me are 81,853.34. क्या हुआ ये सब करके? Can I say the net FC payable receivable 50,000 I will get from my investment and that I will use the same amount that I received to make the payment. So can I say the pound exposure is cut, foreign exposure is cut off, right? But uske liye can I say I have to borrow the funds today and I have to make a payment at maturity. So can I say my liability is converted entirely into my home currency? Through MMC, I converted my exposure to home currency. Understood how this has happened? Can I say through this hedging technique I cancelled my exposure, similar to what I used to do in forward cover, but in this case I am not using my forward rate, instead I am using the spot rate and the interest rate differentials between the two countries, right? Because I am entering into a borrowing and an investment transaction with the bank or the authorized dealer who is going to give me a loan or against whom I am going to make the investment of funds to, right? Clear? Understood? Now we go to the next theory, which is nothing but the purchasing power parity theory. PPP theory bolte usko. अभी जो हमने किया था, the theory that we did right now, that is the interest rate parity theory. What did that theory intend to say? Can I say it told that the forward rate is nothing but the spot rate and a result of the interest rate differential between the two countries? So the purchasing power parity theorem says that true, that interest rate is a parameter, but can I say inflation rate differences between both the countries is also a parameter for affecting the exchange rate between the two countries, right? So PPP kya bolta hai? The forward rate is nothing but a result of the interaction between the spot rate and the inflation rate differential between two countries. So supposing if it is a rupee per dollar rate, then RA is equal to the inflation rate in India, that is rupees, and RB is equal to the inflation rate in US, that is dollars. The mathematics that is involved entirely in the purchasing power parity theorem is the same as your interest rate parity theorem. Understood? But वहां पर हम लोग word क्या use करते थे? Can I say we used to say the forward rate, right? In this theory, the terminology that we use instead of forward rate is the expected spot rate. Understood? Clear? Expected spot rate at the end of year one is equal to the spot today. Upon spot today is equal to 1 plus RA upon 1 plus RB. Supposing they ask you to calculate the expected spot at the end of the third year, then it will be equal to 1 plus RA upon 3 divided by 1 plus RB into spot today. Or it will be equal to expected spot at the end of the first year into 1 plus RA square upon 1 plus RB square, or it is equal to expected spot at the end of the second year into 1 plus RA upon 1 plus RB. And expected spot at the end of first year kaise milta hai? Can I say 1 plus RA upon 1 plus RB into S0, right? And can I say expected spot at the end of the year, second year, can I say is nothing but expected spot at the end of 1 year into 1 plus RA upon 1 plus RB, or can I say it is equal to spot today into 1 plus RA the whole square upon 1 plus RB the whole square, right? Clear? Mathematics involved is the same that you used to have in your interest rate parity theorem. Us maths ke funde mein koi change nahi aaya hai. It is only that instead of I, now we are using inflation, right? इसी के साथ now we move to the next theory, which is the international फिशर इफेक्ट, इसको आईएफई बोलते हैं. व्हाट डिड मिस्टर फिशर से? ही टोल्ड दैट बेस्ड ऑन द आईआरपी द फॉरवर्ड रेट अपॉन स्पॉट रेट इज नथिंग बट the forward rate is nothing but the spot rate into the interest rate differentials of both the countries, right? And he told that as per the purchasing power parity theorem, the expected spot rate at the end of the year is nothing but the spot rate into the inflation rate differentials between the two countries, right? 1 plus RA अपॉन 1 प्लस आर बी. सो फिशर साथ क्या बोलते हैं? दैट सिंस दिस रेट दैट इज द फॉरवर्ड ऑफ द एक्सपेक्टेड स्पॉट रेट इज अ पैरामीटर ऑफ द इंटरेस्ट रेट डिफरेंशियल्स और द इन्फ्लेशन रेट डिफरेंशियल्स ऑफ टू कंट्रीज. गिवन द इंटरेस्ट रेट डिफरेंशियल ऑफ टू कंट्रीज वी कैन फाइंड द इन्फ्लेशन रेट इन द अदर कंट्री और वाइस वर्सा. मतलब वो क्या बोलते हैं? सिंपल, A is equal to B, B is equal to C, therefore A is equal to C. So he means to say 1 plus inflation rate of A upon 1 plus inflation rate of B is equal to 1 plus inflation rate, interest rate and inflation rates of A and B, right? This is nothing but the formula as per the international Fisher effect. समझा ये पार्ट कि ये फॉर्मूला कैसे आया? क्लियर? दिस इज नथिंग बट द इंटरनेशनल फिशर इफेक्ट. इस पे सम कभी कभी एग्जाम में 5 मार्क के लिए बोनस वाला आ जाता है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, नॉर्मली यू गेट दीज क्वेश्चंस इन योर एग्जाम, राइट? अंडरस्टूड? शैल वी नाउ मूव अहेड टू द नेक्स्ट पार्ट. द नेक्स्ट पार्ट दैट वी हैव इज डीलिंग अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ एक्सपोजर दैट आर फेस्ड बाय एनी firm as such when they are doing their business operations. Types of exposures, right? Can I say the very first type of exposure that any company is subject to when they do their business? Can I say it is nothing but the transaction exposure? And can I say transaction exposure is nothing but the exposure arising on account of the transaction which has been entered into in a currency other than home currency. मतलब खुद की करेंसी छोड़ के जब मैं दूसरी करेंसी में ट्रांजेक्शन एंटर करता हूँ, can I say exposure मेरे सर पे आ गया? Can I say as an Indian when I enter into a transaction for other than rupees, रुपी के अलावा कोई और ट्रांजेक्शन एंटर करता हूँ, can I say problem है, risk है, exposure है मेरे सर. So transaction exposure in simple terms, can I say is nothing but an exposure arising out of exchange rates, right? बराबर. Now दूसरा क्या हो सकता है? What is the second type of exposure that can be faced by any company? Can I say अगर मेरी एक company है in India and I have a foreign company, right? Supposing I have a hold co which is Indian and I have two subsidiaries, right? Subsidiary 1, subsidiary 2. One subsidiary is in Singapore and the other subsidiary is in say in Paris, right? Can I say the subsidiaries will be preparing their accounts in their own currency, right? Own currency मतलब Singapore dollar and Paris की currency क्या है? Can I say Paris is a part of France and France की currency is nothing but euros because it comes under the Europe territory, right? Euros की currency, right? Can I say इन दोनों ने खुद के accounts को खुद की currency में बनाया? But can I say this holding company is required to consolidate the accounts of these subsidiary companies in its consolidated financial statements, and can I say it will have to present this currency in the functional currency, and let us say the functional currency is INR. Can I say when I convert this into rupee, when I convert this into rupee, there will be any gain or loss that will arise in my books of accounts on account of foreign currency exchange, जो इंडियस में अगर तुम पढ़ते हो तो कहने से FCTR के नाम से जानते हो उसको, foreign currency translation reserve नाम का एक reserve बनता है books of account में, FCTR, which is a reserve created on account of differences of profit or loss generated on account of consolidation of the books of the foreign currency into the foreign subsidiary into the home currency वाला holding company, right? So can I say the next exposure after transaction exposure is nothing but can I say the translation exposure, right? Can I say this is nothing but an exposure arising on account of conversion of financial statements of foreign companies into home currency, right? And thirdly, one of the most important types of exposures which cannot be negated or which cannot be eliminated under any circumstance is nothing but the economic or operating exposure. This is simply the exposure that supposing I am an Indian company, I have set up my other branch or company in the US or in Singapore or in France, take it anywhere. I would have set it up over there assuming that I would be able to make enough business, assuming that my products have demand over there. I would have done my product analysis, product market penetration analysis, matlab product related har analysis maine kiya hoga, then I would have decided to enter into that particular country and expand my product base and expand my service line, right? Now tell me if the demand does not turn out to be as expected. Us country mein maine socha tha ki mere 50,000 goods per annum bikenge. I assume that 50,000 goods per annum would be sold in France. But what happens is the demand is such that I'm not even able to sell 10,000 goods. Can I say this risk or this exposure came in my books of accounts or came to my business, can I say, because of the demand and supply parameters of the economy of France, right? Matlab, can I say it is nothing but any exposure which occurs on account of any economic parameter of any company, of any country, right? So can I say exposure on account of the economic dynamic situation, economic dynamics of the country, right? Can I say now I can eliminate the transaction exposure, can I say, by hedging, right? I can also eliminate the translation exposure to some extent by entering into hedging modes, right? इधर भी हेजिंग की पॉसिबिलिटी एक है, राइट? और आई कैन टेल देम टू मेंटेन द अकाउंट्स बेस्ड ऑन their करेंसी एज वेल एज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द होम करेंसी दैट इज INR बेस्ड ऑन द एक्चुअल ट्रांजैक्शन डेट. वैसे भी मैं उनको बोल सकता हूँ टू मेंटेन एंड आई कैन टेक देम, राइट? बट देन आई हैव टू सी वेदर माई गैप अलाउज इट और नॉट, राइट? एंड can I say this is an exposure, economic exposure, which I cannot eliminate at all? There is no mechanism left with me to eliminate this loss arising on account of the economic dynamic scenario of any country, right? So can I say these two risks are eliminatable? I don't know whether such word exists in English, but I have made it up, eliminatable. But can I say this is not eliminatable, right? So are we clear with the three types of exposure? Transaction exposure arising on account of the transaction entered into other than home currency, translation exposure, exposure arising on account of conversion of financial statements of foreign companies into holdco companies currency, and the last one is the economic or the operating scenario, that is nothing but the exposure on account of the economic dynamics of any country as such, right? Clear? Now we go to the next part of this chapter, which is leading and lagging. ये नाम से लगता क्या है? Leading मतलब क्या ना, इसे making a payment in advance. Leading मतलब can I say in simple terms, leading means to prepone, and can I say lagging means to postpone, right? So now tell me, will I enter into a preponing or a postponing situation without any analysis, or I will analyze? Ideally I will analyze. On what basis will I analyze? Can I say I will prepone the payment? Can I say if the exchange rates are in my favor? And similarly, I can say that I will postpone the payment if the exchange rates on postponement are in my favor. Right? Can I say when I prepone, I am making payment early or I am receiving payment early? Right? नॉर्मली प्रीपोन करना या पोस्टपोन करना किसका डिसीजन होता है? योर डेटर और क्रेडिटर चूजेस दिस ऑप्शन. कैन आई से फॉर यू अ क्रेडिटर विल चूज द ऑप्शन. सो कैन आई से इन दिस केस यू आर अ क्रेडिटर एंड द क्रेडिटर मे वॉन्ट टू प्रीपोन द पेमेंट इफ एक्सचेंज रेट्स आर इन हिज फेवर. राइट? मतलब कैन आई से फॉर टू मंथ्स व्हेन ही कंप्यूट्स ही हैज टू पे रुपीज 40 lakhs, बट इफ ही पेज एट द एंड ऑफ 3 months, दैट इज द नॉर्मल क्रेडिट पीरियड, his amount say comes to rupees 40 lakhs 25,000. Can I say he would be willing to pay you 40 lakhs today? Right? Save 25,000 of this amount of his payment that would go there. Right? And also invest the amount of 25,000 that he has saved for this period of 3 months. Right? He would save and get interest on that amount. Right? So in net term 25,000 se zyada save kiya us bande ne. Right? Postpone kyu karta? Supposing the normal credit period was 2 months and I had to pay 40 lakhs 10,000. After 1 month preponement, the rate is such that I have to pay 40 lakhs only. And interest rate is equal to kitna percent per annum? Say 8% per annum. So 1 month ka kitna aega? Can I say 0.67% for 1 month? Right? 0.67% पे अभी मैं interest लगाता हूँ because I have to pay this much amount to him. Right? Supposing this was dollars, 1 lakh which I had to pay at rupee per dollar 40.10. This day the exchange rate is rupee per dollar 40. मतलब dollar has depreciated, rupee has appreciated. Right? Can I say 1 लाख मुझे पे करना था, उसके ऊपर I have to pay 1.0067% इंटरेस्ट. राइट? कैन आई से I have to pay डॉलर्स 666.67. राइट? कैन आई से एट रुपी पर डॉलर 40. एट द एंड ऑफ 3 months कितना पे करना है मेरे को? कैन आई से I have to pay रुपीज 40,26,667. Right? Would I lag my payment by 1 month? नहीं, क्योंकि एक महीने के लिए 666 dollars I have to pay. Although the exchange rate has reduced, can I say cause of interest my net outflow has increased from 40,10,000 to 40,26,667? Right? So in this case I would decide not to lead. Supposing lag. This case it was 40,30,000 and the exchange rate was 40.30. Can I say if I make the payment at 2 months, I have to make itne ka kharcha 40,30,000? But can I say if I make the payment after 1 month delay, I will have to pay rupee per dollar, rupees 40,20,000. In this case, can I say I will decide to lag the payment? Right? Mota moti samjha? This is nothing but your concept of leading and lagging as such. Understood?